Today we are going to look at AppID, which is a traffic classification system available in Palo Alto Firewalls. AppID is a traffic classification system. Right. So basically AppID determines what an application is irrespective of port, protocol or encryption or any other evasive tactic used by the application. But let's first understand how legacy firewalls identify applications. Right. So legacy firewall look at layer 3 header like IP header and layer 4 header in order to identify the applications. So they just look at the layer 3 header like source and destination IP address and then layer 4 header, particularly destination port number, destination port address. Right? There is no application intelligence, no application aware inspection, like they operate up to layer 4 of the OSI model. So if like the destination port is let's say TCP 80. Right, so it is identified as a OWEF traffic, right? No matter whether it's a genuinely OWEF traffic or not, but since the destination port is 80, it means it's a standard OWEF browsing traffic. If the destination port is like UDP 53, then identified as a DNS traffic, right? So a lot of evasive tactics can be used to bypass legacy firewalls, right? A lot of evasive tactics, for example, evasive tactics like port or maybe protocol hopping, right? Maybe tunneling inside another protocol or tunneling inside SSH or SSL tunnel, right? So legacy firewalls means like by using evasive tactics they can be bypassed. But nowadays, since we have next generation firewalls like the Palo Alto, Checkpoint, FortiGate or maybe Cisco FTD, they are next generation firewalls. So basically next generation firewalls, they do not only just inspect layer 3 and layer 4 header or like the destination port. Basically they just look at the layer 7 header like the layer 7 data and they apply signatures in order to identify the application. For example, here in Palo Alto firewall, traffic is first matched against policy to check whether it is allowed on the network or not. Then signatures are applied to allow traffic to identify the application based on unique application properties and related transaction characteristics, right? And the signature also determines if the application is being used on its default port or it is using a non-standard port. Let me show you, like because this Palo Alto firewall has approximately 2,898 application signatures in its database, right? So they can be easily identified. So if look at this option here, so objects, then applications, and here total there are 2,898 applications, 2,898 well-known application signature, right? And application is basically a software, a program like Ping, Traceroute, SSH, Telnet, Facebook, Google, Gmail, they all are applications. So application not necessarily means only HTTP and HTTPS base. No, right? And even out of 2,898 applications, 834 applications belong to business system category, 617 collaboration, 457 general internet. Again, then they are like they have been classified on the basis of subcategories, then technology wise, and then risk level, right? A risk level from 1 to 5, 1 is like no risk applications, 5 means high risk applications, and then the characteristics, right? Even we can have security policy here in Palo Alto Firewall to block applications which belong to a specific category, or maybe on the basis of their risk levels. Because here there are two different options here. One is application groups, another one is application filters. So application group is like a static grouping of applications, like just putting different applications in one group manually by the administrator. And this application filter is dynamic group membership. For example, if I apply a filter here, that is to put all risk 5 applications, so all 137 applications will be put into application filter group, and then by applying a security policy, we may block or allow those applications. Even in future, let's say like the 5 new applications are added here with the risk level 5, so this figure goes to now 137 plus 5, which is 142. So now 142 applications will be allowed or blocked, like that depends like what kind of security policy we have, right? So Palo Alto Firewall has like signature database, right? And signature also determines whether applications are being used on their default ports or non-standard port. But important point to note here is like this, like let me open, notepad here. Okay, so it's my Palo Alto Firewall, right? Let's say I have applied a security policy here to block DNS traffic, right? DNS. So the very first packet, DNS query packet, arrives here on Palo Alto Firewall. The very first, and this will have IP and then UDP header and then DNS header, right? So Palo Alto Firewall will first look at layer 3 header in order to check the, like, verify the source and destination IP and some other stuff like protocol number, etc. And then UDP header, and let's say it finds port number 53 here, right? It means it's a standard port of DNS. Then it just goes to upper layer, like layer 7 data, and applies signature of DNS database here. And if it identifies as a DNS application and the security policy doesn't allow DNS traffic, so this will get blocked here, right? What happens if another TCP based application, let's say I have applied a security policy here to block any TCP based application. For example, let's say I have applied a policy to block this, my website, like nettech.org.in here, which is basically just a standard HTTP based application. In fact, it's just running on a standard port 80, right? And at the, so let's say I have a security policy to allow this, and maybe another application running on the same HTTP port, that has to be blocked. So now the question here is, how does Palo Alto Firewall know, like, whether it's ABC application or XYZ application? Because what happens, TCP is basically a connection oriented protocol, right? So the very first packet which comes here will not have data in it, only IP and TCP, right? It's a send message, the very first packet. So this can be either allowed or denied just on the basis of either a layer 3 address or maybe layer 4 address. Right? Here there is no point of applying a application signature here because there is no data in it, right? So definitely this will be allowed. Then SYN packet is allowed. SYNEC comes back here. The third one, acknowledgement. Once TCP connection is successfully established, and then the first packet, application packet, right, which will have IP, TCP, and of course data in it, which this packet arrives here on the firewall, and then firewall will apply its application signature to identify that specific application. It means TCP based applications can be identified or will be identified after three-way handshake, whereas UDP based applications, they can be identified from the very first packet, because the first packet has will have data data in fact payload, right? But TCP based application, no. Let me show you. Okay, so I have a Palo Alto firewall here, and it's a very simple topology here. It's my Palo Alto firewall. External interface which goes to internet side, Ethernet 1/2 external or outside zone, Ethernet 1/1 internal interface connects to my LAN or trusted zone here, and I have a Windows machine here, like a test PC sort of thing. So only testing from here, and this interface IP, like which is gateway for this Windows machine, and this IP address is 50, that is 172.16.0.50. So 172.16.0.1 will be used as a gateway IP address for this Windows test machine, right? So let's create a security policy and NAT policy, source NAT, right? So very quick here. So policy, and there is no policy here. So intra zone and inter zone, they both are implicit security policy in Palo Alto firewall, by default created, and they cannot be deleted. So in order to create a new security policy, just click here add. So first, like, select this policies tab, and then on the left hand side security, and then security policy rule, and let's say it's a inside to outside internet traffic rule, internet traffic, and source address. So source zone is like my inside zone, source address. If I have a network object here, yes, I have destination zone, outside destination address any, and application here, right? So let me put some application here, DNS, sorry, so DNS, very quick here, and then another application, standard browsing, so web browsing, sorry, web browsing is basically HTTP, and let me put in here like SSL, right? So the third one is, third application is SSL application, and one more, let me trace route. This route, and one more application here, Google base, that's all, right? And then service default port action and session at the start end, and a very quick NAT policy here, just like a many to one translation here. It is known as source address NAT, RS NAT sort of thing. Just give any name here, it's just the name, source zone, But names should be meaningful, very descriptive, because in case if you have like 100, 200 security policies, so it's very difficult to find out any specific security policy or NAT policy. So even it's just name, but the name should be meaningful or very descriptive. So destination zone here, outside, and source address, this entire network destination is any, and translated packet is like dynamic IP, and port under this source address translation is a SNAT, and then translated address is interface IP, and is external interface, and directly goes to MySP network. So it's all good. So security policy, and security policy, if you look at the security policy here, so this security policy allows DNS, Google base, SSL, trace route, and web browsing, right? Google base only, right? So SSL means standard SSL application, like those SSL applications for which this Palo Alto firewall doesn't have signature. And web browsing means HTTP based applications, and basically those applications which are not here, like in this application database, right, they all will be allowed. But SSL, allowing less SSL doesn't mean like Facebook, LinkedIn, and Gmail, these applications will be allowed. No, because Palo Alto firewall does have signature for them, so they will not be allowed here, right? So let's see what happens now. Let me push this policy. Okay, it's almost done. Inside to outside application dependency warning, this ICMP is allowed, and application trace out requires ping be allowed. So there is some dependency in it, and some are implicitly used, but if there is dependency, then you need to add them. So let me add ping in fact here. Okay, so ping, and even better to just add this ping in order to test IP reachability or IP connectivity. So commit one more time. That's very quick, Palo Alto firewall. And if we talk about any other firewall like checkpoint firewall, so it takes very much time. So ICMP, no problem now, no problem whatsoever. ICMP is no issue at all. All right, let's just start with the ping first, and then so ping perfect, it's working, and let's look up. So cisco.com is working fine. What about google.com? google.com, yes, it's working here. What if I type in here like facebook.com? So definitely I will get DNS reply of this facebook.com, right? Because the first packet will be like DNS query packet, and then DNS reply, and then TCP 3-way handshake, and then finally application ID will get applied, and finally Facebook will get blocked, because Facebook is not explicitly allowed in the security policy. And since Palo Alto firewall has signature for facebook.com or Facebook application, so that application has to be explicitly allowed in the security policy, right? So if I try to open Facebook, so or maybe LinkedIn or any other application, so should not work, right? Facebook.com should not work, unless not, right? All right, so let me show you the log here. So web browsing is allowed, and let me find this Facebook base. Facebook base and apply this. So 28 yet. Yes, perfect. So Facebook base, and you may look at this drop action, right? So it's getting dropped with the interzone default policy, right? This is the implicit policy, because Palo Alto Firewall has signature for this application Facebook base, so that is why it's dropped. Let me alright. So Facebook base is identified and not allowed by this, right? So now is there any way like that we could have just minimize resource utilization, like because Palo Alto Firewall is allowing DNS query packets. So let me open this Wireshark and capture some DNS packet here. Let's say I say NS lookup, or just any packet, like let's say I need to have IP address of cisco.com. Let me close down this. Let's open the DNS packet. So DNS query packet, here it is, right? So it's a UDP based packet, so which uses, in general it uses UDP port 53, but sometimes even TCP. I don't want to get into those stuff as of now, but here like it's a DNS query packet. So a DNS query packet will have query message here, right? Like name and some other stuff. And let me the very first, and then it's a response and another one for different. It's a Microsoft.com and then Cisco.com. Here it is, like this one, right? Cisco.com, right? So basically what happens at this point of time, Palo Alto Firewall applies its DNS signature to identify the DNS. So first it looks at layer 4 header, like which is UDP header, and if it finds a standard port which is 53, then Palo Alto Firewall goes to upper layer, like layer 7 DNS, and it applies its DNS signature to identify whether it's DNS or not. But Palo Alto Firewall doesn't look at the like query message, like for which domain you are asking about the IP address, right? Is the domain name is cisco.com, and what's the security policy, right? Because for that we need to create, either there has to be DNS signature or we need to create that. So if we create a DNS signature in Palo Alto application signature database, then what will happen, Palo Alto Firewall will apply its DNS signature and will identify like for which domain name you want to get the IP address. So maybe this like resource utilization can be minimized. Let me show you like how all this can be possible. So very quick here, close down this, get without saving, no point of saving that. And here, yes, so if I go to objects, applications, add, and let me create a custom FB DNS signature. It's just name, so you may give any name. Just FPTNS signature, and your category is like, let's say general internet category, subcategory is internet utility and technology is like browser based. It's all good and it's all optional, so you may go to the advanced tab and the port number, and its port number is UDP 53. Okay, and then signature here, DNS request header. So let me give the name FB DNS signature, and then and or condition, and then the pattern match context is like DNS request section and request, like let's say facebook.com. okay, facebook.com, apply here. Okay, all good, and then finally post this policy. And whenever you create a custom application signature, so usually it takes time. So took time here, and let me go to that Windows machine here one more time. So initially we were getting IP address of facebook.com. Now one more time here, look at the output here, right? No IP address, right? So since like there is a DNS signature for this application facebook.com, so whenever the very first packet, which is DNS query packet, reaches Palo Alto firewall, so it applies DNS signature for Facebook, and since explicitly is not allowed, so that DNS query packet is dropped by the Palo Alto firewall. So in this way we may like, you know, like minimize resource utilization by creating this, because it's the very first step. Whenever you try to open any application like facebook.com or whatever, so the very first step is what? DNS query goes to DNS server, in case if you don't have your local DNS server, right? So if you don't have local DNS server, then definitely you will be using either open DNS or maybe your ISP DNS server, or maybe 888 as the DNS server. So the very first step will be obtaining IP address of domain name, like here facebook.com, that is a standard DNS query packet, and then DNS response message. And whenever you get response back from the DNS server, then TCP connection is negotiated, TCP three-way handshake. Once TCP connection is done, established, right? Once TCP connection is done, then a standard application request packet comes onto the firewall, which will have a payload, and then Palo Alto firewall will apply application signature, because TCP, again like TCP three-way handshake, no data in that. Prior to that, before like three-way handshake, DNS query and DNS reply packet, right? So that's just standard DNS packet. In case if you like don't have local DNS server, you don't have your enterprise DNS server, then only, right? If you have local DNS server, so definitely client request will go to your local DNS server, and then if local DNS server will check in its cache or maybe a database table, and if local DNS server doesn't find any matching entry for that specific domain name, then local DNS server forwards or query to any external DNS server, or maybe open DNS server or root end servers, right? In order to get the IP address. So here like application ID is very good feature of this Palo Alto firewall, and since we are also we can create like custom signatures or signatures for homegrown applications or DNS signatures, and even we may put applications under this application filter. For example, like let's say if you say here is my risk 5 apps, right, and select here only, it's a filter, right? So look at the output here, only risk 5 applications have been selected here, right? So this is the criteria, risk label, then and then just go to your security policy. You may create a security policy here to block a RISC-V, all RISC-V applications. So go to security tab and here like add a new security policy here on top of it. So name it like block RISC-V apps. So source like maybe inside to outside and source address anybody from this IP subnet, and then the destination is your outside zone, destination any, and then the application. So look for that specific application group here. So RISC-V apps, so just look for this RISC-V apps, right? And then here block drop, right? So just put this rule on top of it. So in this way, like you may create or this application filters, and this application group is like a static membership of application. Like for example, if you want to put 10 or 20 applications in one group, so you may create here like let's say browsing apps or something like, and then you may add here like different applications in this group, but it's a static membership. It's not dynamic, it's a static, it's all manual, right? So you may create this application group like DNS. You may put here web browsing, or maybe SSL as per the requirement. So you may put different applications here in one group, but it's a static group membership. Static, it's not the dynamic. Application filter is dynamic membership, like, and we may select any criteria like category, subcategory, risk level, etc. So here like there are three different options: applications, application group, and application filters, right? And if we conclude this discussion, so now the final conclusion is like Palo Alto Firewall being the next generation firewall, it applies application signatures to identify applications, and is you know, like, and even in case if let's say it's my Palo Alto Firewall is internet cloud, internal network. So in order to control sub applications or micro applications, right? Because once you know like a tunnel is established or negotiated with the destination by this client, maybe SSL tunnel, and if packets are tunneled inside this SSL, it means the payload will be encrypted now. This data portion. So we may control like SSL based applications, right? But to control micro or sub applications, there has to be decryption policy here, right? So this even application ID, if it finds encrypted data, so it looks for decryption policy. So there has to be SSL decryption policy, then this data is decrypted, and then again application ID is applied here. Application signatures are applied here, because without SSL decryption policy, it's very difficult to control sub applications. Because once tunnel is established, so what you are sending across this tunnel, any firewall cannot, you know, like inspect that traffic. Any firewall, no matter whether it's a Palo Alto checkpoint or any other firewall, there has to be some SSL decryption mechanism. Like here in Palo Alto firewall, we have SSL decryption policy. In checkpoint firewall, we have HTTPS inspection, right? But there has to be some mechanism, right? So without SSL decryption policy, SSL based applications can be managed, can be controlled, but we cannot control sub applications or micro applications, right? So I think it makes sense.